This is the BBC.
This podcast is supported by advertising outside the UK.
Tired of ads interrupting your favorite show? Good news. Ad-free listening on Amazon Music is included with your Prime membership. Keep your finger on the pulse with shows like The Ezra Klein Show and Scamfluencers uninterrupted at amazon.com/adfreelifestyle. Just head to amazon.com/adfreelifestyle to catch up on the latest episodes without the ads. Acast Network shows are ad-free for Prime subscribers. Other shows may have ads.
BBC Sounds. Music, radio, podcasts.
BBC Radio 2. 10 to the top.
Wednesday's 10 to the top. And it is time to meet contestant number one, who is Elaine Barr in Belfast. Hello, Elaine.
That's me. Hi, Gary. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm not so bad, thank you. Excited to be talking to the Gary Davis.
Oh, well, I'm excited to be talking to the Elaine Barr.
The one and only.
The one and only, because apparently you're a pretty good softball player.
I'm not sure I would go that far, but I did play for Ireland last year for the national team in the European Championships in Slovenia. So that's not too bad, I guess.
I think that's pretty darn brilliant. Tell me about softball.
So softball is quite like baseball, mixed in with a little bit of rounders. You know, I used to play rounders at school, yep. Kind of like that. So you play with a baseball bat. It is not a softball. It's a hard ball. Okay. It can hurt. And the rest of the rules are pretty much like baseball, but it's a mixed team. So it's boys and girls play together.
Oh, brilliant. Brilliant.
Yeah, it's good fun.
And is it a very popular sport now?
It's getting more popular. It's really popular in the United States, kind of all of the Americas, China, Australia, all that kind of thing. But in the UK and Ireland, there's maybe 45 teams across Ireland and quite a few more across England, Scotland and Wales. Mm-hmm. So it's getting more popular.
And your last concert, like me, was Bruce Springsteen.
It was, yeah. I saw him in Dublin a couple of months ago. He was so good.
Isn't he brilliant?
Absolutely fantastic.
Have you seen him before?
No, that was my first time I'd ever seen him. I'll definitely go back though.
Yeah, and the band, the E Street Band.
They're just incredible, and the energy they have.
I know.
Unbelievable.
And I think something like the average age of the band is about 68, you know.
Exactly.
Still rocking away. It's superb.
I wish I had their energy right now, never mind at 68.
Well, you don't need a lot of energy for 10 to the top. You just need some guts and a little bit of knowledge. How do you normally do?
I normally do okay. It kind of depends, though. So sometimes I'll do quite well. I'll get 7 or 8, but that can sometimes mean a 20 or it can sometimes mean a 7. So I just have to play my joker in the right spot, I guess.
Well, you know, yesterday 7 was a pretty high score.
Okay, fingers crossed then.
So hopefully you'll do all right. Okay, are you ready, Elaine?
So. I'm ready.
All right, let's do this. Here come your 10 to the top.
To the top on Radio 2.
Question one. Who had a top 20 hit in 1996 with the song Ironic?
Alanis Morissette.
Yeah, Alanis Morissette. Well done. Yeah, up and running. 2 points on this next question. It's a musical clip. One of Bob Marley's best love songs was climbing the top 10 this week in 1980. Here's the intro. See if you can give me the title. Name the title.
Is it Could You Be Loved?
Is the correct answer. Well done. Question number three. Kurt Smith and Roland Orzabal are founder members of which group?
Tears for Fears?
You weren't sounding so sure about your answer.
I wasn't sure. I only learned that fact this week.
Did you?
Yeah, honestly.
Where did you learn that?
I think I might have heard it on your show, maybe last week on Vernon's.
Yeah.
Somebody mentioned it.
Yeah, quite
possible.
I
tucked it away.
And also a lot of talk about Tears for Fears because they're one of the top acts on the lineup for Radio 2 in the Park in Leicester in September.
Of course.
4 points on your next question, Elaine. Name the band who reached the top five in January 2005 with the song Filthy Gorgeous.
Sister Sisters.
Yay! So, 5 points on the next question. You tempted to play a joker yet? Are you going to hang on?
I'm really tempted. I'm going to hold on a wee bit longer.
Okay, your choice. For 5 points, what type of feet did Mudd sing about on the 1974 number one single?
Tiger feet.
Yeah! Woo! 6 points coming up now on this. Okay, who spent 5 weeks at number one in 1991 with the Shoop Shoop song?
Sure.
Absolutely brilliant. You're flying. Wow.
Yeah, so far so good.
So far,
I'm scared now.
So far, very, very good. Not tempted to play a joker? I'm not persuading you either way. It's entirely up to you.
I'm going to hold on tiny bit longer.
All right. This is for 7 points. How are you on your years?
Oh, we'll see. I got both of yesterday's right, so obviously I'll be like 15 years out today.
Oh, I've got high hopes for you.
No, I don't.
In what year did the song I Owe You Nothing give Bros their only number one single?
1989. I'm 1 year out.
Oh, no.
It was 1988, wasn't it?
It was 88.
Oh, no.
Oh, you were going so well.
Ah, that'll teach me. It's all right.
Well, look on the bright side. At least you didn't play your joker on that question.
That's true.
Yeah, and we still have 1, 2, 3 more questions to go. So you can build up a bit of a run if you get these right, okay?
Yeah.
Here's a chorus from a top three song that was this band's debut hit in 1979. For 1 point, who are they?
Are they Sad Cafe?
They are. Paul Young was their lead singer, but not the same Paul Young who had big solo hits in the 80s. Sad Cafe's Paul was the guy who later joined Mike and the Mechanics. Okay, you're climbing up the ladder again. 2 points on the next one. Complete the title of this number one chart debut from 2010 by Ollie Murs. Please don't what?
Please don't leave me. Please don't let me go.
Yes, too late. I like the rapping of the fingers on the table while you're trying
to decide
the answer.
I know this, except not quick enough.
Yeah. Please don't let me go. Back down to 1 point. You haven't played your joker. You're going to play it now. This is for 2 points, and your final question. Name the group whose only top 40 hit was the 1986 song, What's the Colour of Money?
Oh, I forget their name. I don't know.
Hollywood Beyond. How many do you reckon you got?
1, 2, 3.
That's that one. You can be around 22. Mm.
22. Okay, that's decent. That's good. I'm happy with 22.
It's more than decent. It's an excellent score. Whether it's enough, we'll be down to Wayne Saunders in Crewe, who's coming up next. We'll find out how he does right after this.
Call Jonathan Pie. I want something better than that. No.
What's wrong with Call Jonathan Pie?
It's really boring.
OK, so let's all do a brain fart. Actually, what about that? Jonathan Pie's brain fart. Ugh. It's hilarious.
Jonathan Pie, off my chest.
Off my chest?
Chewing the fat, chewing the pie.
Chewing the cud.
Cud? The title for my new phone-in show is Jonathan Pie Chews His Own Sit.
I'm just spitballing. Let's just spitball.
Jonathan Pie spits balls.
Should we just stick with Call Jonathan Pie?
Yes.
Call Jonathan Pie. Listen first on BBC Sounds.
BBC Radio 2. 10 to the top.
And contestant number two today is in Crewe in Cheshire, and he is Wayne Saunders. Hello, Wayne.
Hi, Gary. You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. And you?
Yeah. Good, sir.
Good. Big country music fan, I hear.
Yeah, big country fan.
Good. So you listen to Bob Harris every week?
Yeah, when I can. Yeah. I'm usually playing football at that time of the night, to be fair, on a Thursday. So I tend to miss him, but catch the back end of it sometimes. So
we'll catch it on BBC Sounds, of course.
Yes, I can do. Yes, sometimes I do.
Who do you play football for?
It's just a veterans league. I'm at that age now, you know, over 35. And, you know, it's a team. We sort of played together for years, off and on. And then we're playing like a little mini league now, just on a Thursday night on AstroTurf. So yeah, it's quite competitive and keeps me trim, hopefully.
Yeah, and how are you doing in the league?
It's just finished actually, and I think we finished. It was either first or second. I can't remember exactly because, you know, we play it to win, obviously, but, you know, it's just a case of, you know, it's more of a social thing really. So yeah, we're not doing too bad.
Brilliant. And your dream is to travel around America as a family in an RV.
Oh, that's the dream, isn't it, Gary? I think, you know, to go places, you know, sort of Nashville and obviously, you know, places like that, you know, sort of would dream but love to go, really. So, yeah, definitely that is the dream.
Yeah, especially these American RVs. I mean, they are just magnificent, a lot of them, aren't they?
Oh, they're massive, aren't they? I mean, you know, you need a sat-nav just to get to the back of one, I think, sometimes.
Well, Elaine posted a pretty decent score, 22.
She did well, yeah. I got a couple of hers right, so, yeah, it was, it's one of them, and it's you know, the luck of the draw on the day, as they say.
Absolutely. Right questions, right time.
Yeah, that's it.
Let's hope today is your day.
Fingers crossed.
All right, all the best to you. You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Let's do this.
To the top on Radio 2.
Question 1. On his 1994 hit single, Bruce Springsteen sang about the streets of which American city?
Philadelphia.
Quick. It was the streets of Philadelphia. Question 2. Name the TV reality group who made their chart debut in 2001 with Pure and Simple.
It was,
quick.
No, it's gone.
You're going to kick yourself. Hearsay.
Hearsay, that is it.
Yeah. Ugh. Back down to 1 point. On their 1987 number one, what did the band Mars ask us to pump up?
Pump up the volume.
Yes. Pump up the volume is correct. 2 points on the next question. It's a musical clip. From this week's top five, exactly 30 years ago, here's a debut hit that was all over the radio. What's the name of the group performing it? The name of the group?
Is it Four Non-Blondes?
Four Non-Blondes it is. Well done. 3 points on your next question. In 1984, a cover of which famous Casey and the Sunshine Band song gave Dead or Alive their debut hit? What's the title?
Is it Baby Give It Up? No, not that one.
No, it's not. It's That's the Way I Like It.
Ah.
Uh-huh.
Now I know, yeah.
Yeah. Back down to one, I'm afraid.
Okay.
In what year did Rod Stewart spend a month at number one with the song Sailing?
1978?
No, it was 1975.
Ooh.
Yeah.
About that.
Not to worry. Still, okay. For 1 point. On her 2008 top three debut, Adele said she was chasing what?
Pavements.
Yes. Excellent. 2 points. Ooh. On your next question. The Shaman had a top 10 hit in 1992 with LSI. But what did the initials stand for?
Love, Sex and Intelligence.
Excellent. What a great answer. Well done. Love, Sex, Intelligence.
Taking me back to my brave days then.
Yeah. So you have 3 points on this next question.
Okay.
The Carole King song, You've Got a Friend, was a top 10 hit in 1971 for James who?
James... Oh, what's his second name? No, it's gone, Gary.
James Taylor.
Taylor, that's it. Eluding me, these second names.
Yeah. Joni Mitchell did the backing vocals on James's version, and James played acoustic guitar on Carol's original.
All yeah. Right.
So, your final question, you not played your joke, are you going to play it now? For 2 points, let's end on a high. Here's a song that leapt into the top 10 this week in 1979. Who's the musician singing it?
Guess, is it Joe Walsh?
No, sorry.
No.
It's actually Dave Edmunds. Oh, well, listen, 7 points, not bad.
Okay, yeah, that's not too bad. Yeah.
It's all right. Yesterday we were giving you a tiebreaker. but today, I'm afraid, Elaine Barr with 22. You did good, Elaine. Well done.
Well done, Elaine.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm glad I didn't get your questions, dude.
Anyway, listen, Wayne, it's been a pleasure speaking to you.
And you, Gary. And you, Gary.
And,
appreciate it.
We will send you a 10 to the top mug.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Thanks, Gary.
That's all right. All the best. And Elaine, wow.
I was worried. He started off pretty well. Yeah. I was starting to get concerned.
Well, it turned out well for you in the end. You get yourself a Radio 2 smart speaker.
Oh, fantastic. Thank you so much.
Lovely speaking to you, Elaine.
You too. Thanks, Gary. Bye. Bye.
So there you go. Elaine Barr in Belfast wins with 22 points. Now, if you reckon you could do better, 10 to the top at bbc.co.uk is the address you need to apply, or you can register now to play via WhatsApp on 08000 288 291. Just start your message with 10 to the top and include your name and why you should get to play, and all the rules, terms and privacy notice are at bbc.co.uk/10to the top. Plus, don't forget, there's a downloadable scorecard on the Radio 2 website. And over on BBC Sounds, there's a podcast version of the quiz published every day at 11 a.m. We'll be back the same time with more 10 to the Top tomorrow.
10 to the Top on Radio 2.
If you never want to miss another episode of 10 to the Top, just click subscribe on the BBC Sounds app or website to get the daily podcast. Thanks for listening, and I'll see you on the next one.
BBC Sounds. Music, radio, podcasts.
Tired of ads interrupting your favorite show? Good news. Ad-free listening on Amazon Music is included with your Prime membership. Stay motivated and inspired with podcasts like 10% Happier with Dan Harris and Feel Better, Live More with Dr. Rangan Chatterjee. Uninterrupted at amazon.com/adfreefitness. Just head to amazon.com/adfreefitness to catch up on the latest episodes without the ads. Acast Network shows are ad-free for Prime subscribers. Other shows may have ads.